is a community workshop and a concert. You probably have never seen it put together like this. It's gonna be such a tag team dynamic. It's gonna be out of this world. But I'm not gonna lecture y'all. I'm not gonna be up here because that's not my turn. No, I have my turn one day. But without further ado, I wanna call two brothers up that inspire me, keep me motivated, keep me focused. You know, watch how I do things. They just the beautiful brothers. They're a dynamic duo. They from my hometown, and they always tear it down. So without further ado, we're gonna call up Precise Science.
Because the commercial radio is not the correct culture. Let's get into this. I'd like to introduce to y'all brothers and sisters the founder, the visionary, the leader of Pan-African Liberation Movement. My brother, your brother, our brother, Imhotep Fatiu.
Imhotep. And I know that as a people, we are deeply entrenched in a lot of mess, bullcrap, oppression. Correct?
Correct.
So, I'm going to introduce myself again. My name is Imhotep Fatiu. And what I do is I work with African people to develop African people, to move African people, to educate African people, so we can be free as a people. Does that make any sense to y'all?
Yes.
Sounds good?
Yes.
Three statements of fact. When you came to that door, you should have received the sheet of paper. Because the paper goes with the workshop. And at the end of it, we're gonna review some of those things. The first fact, community development is indispensable to nation building. What does that mean? It means this. Every single African or black organization, every single one that says that they have the best interest of black people at heart should be thinking about nation building. Everything that you do has to move you towards nation building. If nation building is not on your trajectory, then you're doing it for the wrong reasons. And you're in the way. Understood?
Okay.
Community development is ultimately people development. You cannot develop communities if you're not developing people. You cannot develop communities if you are not developing people. So in order for us to develop the communities that we live in, we have to figure out how to develop the people within the community. People development is collective development, which is organized development. The reason that's why is because in order for us to get to the top, which is nation building, which is community development, we need to have organized development, and only organizations can bring about organized development. Only organizations can bring about organized development. 4 R is essential to organizations' effort to community development. A core. Most organizations doesn't have a core. Think about the earth. The earth has a core, and that core is essential to the earth's existence. Correct? Y'all agree? When you think about the universe, thus far as we know the sun sits at the center and everything else revolves around the sun. It keeps everything in harmony and balance. We agree to that?
Yeah.
So organizations need a core. You just can't grab a bunch of people together and say, let's do something. The reason being, because the type of oppression that we have suffered in the last 60 years is a type of oppression that has affected us psychosocially. So we have psychosocial abnormalities that interferes with us coming together as a people. So we need to factor that into the equation when we start trying to organize. You can't grab 50 and 60 people and say, let's just do something. It's going to bust open. Because there's too much hurt amongst us. It's too much inadequacy that we carry around. We got too much weakness. So you got to get a core together, build a core, and build up. The basic law is this: never organize from the macro to the micro. Organize from the micro to the macro. And sometimes it's going to take some time. And I know that we are in a whole lot of oppression, I understand that. But we need to do it the correct way so we don't kickstart moving. So it's just going to take some time to get it right. And in the meantime, yes, we're going to lose some people. Some people are going to go to jail. Some people are going to lose their lives. Some people are going to get their heads busted. It's going to happen because we are fighting from behind enemy's lines. And we just can't keep trying to rush the situation. We gotta take our time to do it the correct way so we can win. You understand that?
Yes.
We need a core. Study. Organizations don't study. They don't study, that's why they become irrelevant. They fall out because they just don't know what's going on for real. You know? You bring an organization into existence and let's say hypothetically speaking, 2010. You got this great organization. You're doing wonderful things. You got these beautiful ideas. 2010, 2015 come around, you're not doing no more studying, you're just moving. But you don't realize that when you stop studying, you become irrelevant because you can no longer keep moving the way you need to move. You can no longer assess the new problems as they occur because you're not what? Developing yourself. You believing that your information that you received 20 years ago still make you qualified to do what you're doing. No, it doesn't. Right. You gotta always want to upgrade knowledge and information. Right. You got to always upgrade knowledge and information. We need to enhance how we socialize. We need to enhance how we engage and interact with one another. I'm gonna tell you why. One of the greatest minds that spoke to us, in my opinion, was Angus Wilson. Angus Wilson teaches, and he taught us, and this is the truth. Your economic systems grows out of your social systems. And I'm gonna tell you why. We can only do business together collectively when we what trust and like each other. And trust and like and respect is social. So when we're broken down socially, it hinders economic development.
Rap is hip-hop's demon seed, conceived when she was raped by greed. See, she didn't believe in abortion, so the youngin' got a chance to earn a portion of his inheritance. Rap was just a shorty then, and he only saw the value of the legacy in terms of dollars and cents. And without the cents God gave him, he chose to slave within the system, to learn the ins and outs of the game and what it was all about to get the fame. Excuse me, folks just broke through me. Like trees, the branches, cliffs, the avalanches. It's the praying mantis, deep like the mind of Farrakhan. A mother rap phenomenon.
Plus,
he thought Mom was stupid for letting all them fat cats abuse her and her music. So he decided he was going to flip the script all the way around and show the industry how to really get down. So he signed on a dotted line, surrendering his soul to the corporate devil in exchange for exposure on a whole nother level. I told you, rap is hip-hop's demon seed, conceived when she was raped by greed.
We are our own worst enemy known. From our own food, leave our enemies alone. Rough microphones in all three dimensions. Hip-hop purists for Pan-African attention. That's without ascension from proper comprehension of the real. Everything you see here is feel as your diet. You gotta live it, we must prohibit toxins and chemicals from damaging the spiritual, audio or visual, and the full of spiritual. It can bring your life force down to critical. So it's better to re-eat the live. Challenge your favorite rapper on what he got to give. What do you eat with killing us? We gotta see that. Hip hop is a culture, we gotta be that. So we can see rap in proper perspective. Bring the DJ back so we can be protected like.
See him coming with the heel.
Yeah.
and it's a behavioral orientation. A mental disposition and a behavioral orientation. Hip hop is a way of life. Hip hop is that which comes from Africa. Hip hop is Africa. Hip hop is a conduit through which socio-political and economic issues are conveyed to the African world.
That's right.
Hip hop is Africa's media. You understand? So when you're thinking about hip hop, you're thinking about that which is speaking to you, from you, about you, to move you to a better spot.